Today I'm going to tell you about all of these built-in interactive tools in MATLAB. You can display a warning, error, question box, wait bar, input box, and so on. So watch until the end. The first group of interactive commands are dialog boxes. To display a message for the user, use msgbox string, title. My message is thank you for your patience. To display a help message, use helpdlg. This time I also add the title. The only difference is this help icon. You can display multiple lines by putting multiple strings inside a cell. The same goes for displaying a warning or error message with warndlg and errordlg. Notice that when you display an error message using the error function, your code stops and it won't perform following lines. I type A equal to 1, B equal to 3, error, I type my error message. F equal to 10. When I run the code, you can see that this line is not executed and we don't have F. But if I use errordlg, the running won't stop and I'll have F. If you want to force stop the code, just use return after errordlg. Now let's ask a question from the user. Questdlg. First I use it with a simple question. Do you want to continue? I can see by default these are the three options. Here I can see MATLAB is busy and I don't see this symbol. So MATLAB is waiting for my answer. And there is a blue border around yes. So if I press enter button, it takes yes as my answer. Let me click no. So my answer is returned as a string. Let's use it in the code. I write a while loop that only stops when the user says so. This is a while loop and at the end of each iteration, it asks the user, do you want to continue? The answer is saved in a variable named s. So for every iteration, we should check if s is equal to yes. The correct way of comparing strings is using strcmp command. If you want to know about this subject, check out my other tutorial right here. While strcmp s, yes, it means while s is equal to yes, the loop will repeat. I initialize s and as long as s is equal to yes, the loop will continue. And I just add a few lines to execute at each iteration. You see that as long as I want to continue, a new bigger matrix is going to be displayed. We can also modify these buttons. The first string here is the question. Next one is considered the title. Now I can add up to 3 buttons. I want only yes and no options. But remember that after entering your buttons, you must specify which one of these buttons is the default one. I choose yes as the default button. List selection box. You can let the user choose from a list of options. Listdlg does that for you. First, you should have your list ready in a cell. So I create a cell named S containing a few color names. Now listdlg list string. You must type it carefully, although it is not case sensitive. And S is my defined list. I can choose whichever I like, and I confirm it by double clicking or hitting OK. You can select multiple items by holding control button. Also, you have a select all option, but for now I choose one color. It returned a number, which is the index of my selected option. So let me store the index of the selected option in a variable, and I want to use the selected color in a bar plot. I define y and I plot it using bar y. Now I add a face color, and to set it as my selected option, I write S of index. So if I choose red, then the index is going to be number 4, And what is the fourth element of S? If the user doesn't select a color and instead clicks on cancel, then the index is going to be empty and I'll face an error. To check if the user has pressed cancel or not, you should add another output argument here, which I named D. So if the user selects a color, D is going to be 1, and if selects cancel, D will be 0. Now I write an if statement. So if the user doesn't select a color, MATLAB plots using the default color. Now a few more options. Prompt string will let you type a message for the user. For example, select the face color. If I set the selection mode to single, then the number of selections will be limited to 1. To see other options, type help listdlg. To let the user select any file from any folder, use uigetfile command. If I want to read this image file, one way is to copy it to my MATLAB current working directory and read it using imread. Or to avoid copying and pasting, read it from the original location using its full address. But sometimes you don't know this address or it changes constantly. Luckily, you can select it from an explorer. File, comma, path equal to uigetfile. Now I can go to my target folder. If you can't see your file, change the file format to all files and here it shows up. If you write uigetfile single quote star single quote, you won't need to change the file type. Now if I select my file, I can see the file name and its path are stored in these variables. So to read the image, I just need to combine this path with this file name. One way is using strcat. Another way is to put them in a vector. I can see my image. Let me add some noise to my image. Now I want to save it. Again, I have the same problem and the same solution. To save it in a specific folder, you must have its address. I use uiputfile this time. And it returns the file name and its path. I go to my desktop and give it a name. The better approach is to specify a format, a title for your input file window, and a name for your output file. So I choose all file formats using a star, select the title, and give my output a name, noisy.png. Now I save my image in the specified folder using imwrite command. Getting input from the user. I type input dlg, enter a number. And I enter 10. I see the input variable is stored in a cell. So I define an output variable and I can see that its first element is my entered number, but in a string format. So I convert it to a number using str:num. To receive another value from the user, I add one more entry, enter a name. But I put all of them inside a cell. Now I can receive two values from the user and I save the second one in a new variable. choosing from millions of colors. I plot a bar graph and using face color, I can change the bar colors to any color, but only if I have the RGB code of the desired color. For example, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5 is the RGB code for gray. I type uisetcolor, and here are a few colors to choose from. I like this one and hit OK. Now I have its RGB color. You can choose custom colors too. I choose a very special color and having its RGB code, I plot my bar graph. A similar command is uisetfont, which allows you to choose from the list of fonts and returns it as a structure. The last function I want to introduce is weightbar. It takes a number between 0 and 1 and fills a weight bar accordingly. So weight bar 0.5 shows a half-filled weight bar. You can use it in your loops to display the progress. First, I create a weight bar and name it H. Then for I equal to 1:100, I refresh my weight bar H with its new value, weight bar I divided by 100, H. I also add a pause to see the progress. Thank you for watching. Please hit the subscribe button and bye bye.